Hey, John.
Hey, Randall, how you doing?
We missed you at the meeting the other day.
Really? Well, what meeting?
We just had a department meeting. We reviewed the new health system policy on gifts and interaction with industry.
You know, there's so many meetings, I can't even keep up with them anymore. Oh, by the way, did you get the invitation for the steak dinner on the 18th?
You mean the one from the device company about the new knee replacement products?
Yeah, that's the one. All we gotta do is sit there, listen to the sales pitch, have some steak, and even enjoy some wine if you want that too.
You know, that sounds great, but there is one little problem.
And what's that?
The new health system policy on gifts and interaction with industry. The one we reviewed at the meeting.
Listen, this isn't a gift. This is just a meal about us sitting down and learning about a new medical device.
From what I can gather, it's okay just under certain circumstances to receive education about a product, but we can't receive food, drinks, or even trinkets from the company presenting. So I guess the steakhouse is out.
That's crazy. Why don't we have them come here, do their presentation during lunchtime, and hey, maybe the rep can even get us some steaks to go.
I like where your creativity's going on that, but no good. As far as the lunch and learn is concerned, the learn is okay, but the lunch isn't.
Wow. So since you got that policy handy, let me ask you this. Pharmaco's asked me to do a consulting job. I do a presentation on one of their new medical devices. They do all the work for me, slides. They've done the prep. I don't have to do anything except show up and talk.
I hate to be the one to have to tell you this, but you can't take that consulting deal either.
But I'm a thought leader in the industry. Pharmaco said so.
Doesn't matter. The policy prohibits speakers bureau type arrangements like the one you just described. We have to be careful about the consulting services we provide and how the industry plans to compensate us for them.
It all sounds so complicated.
It's not really. The requirements for acceptable consulting arrangements are all laid out in the policy. You just have to make sure your arrangements comply with that policy.
Listen, I don't want my consulting work being anybody's business.
Well, maybe that was true in the past, but in a few years, all compensation paid to physicians by healthcare industry vendors will become public information.
The public is going to know about this? What the hell is happening?
Transparency. That's what's happening. Patients have a right to know if physicians receive compensation from industry vendors. It may influence their decisions, treatments, practices. And even if it doesn't influence them, it could create the illusion of improper influence and a conflict of interest.
Really?
And the healthcare system is all about avoiding conflict of interest. They want to be sure that we provide the best possible care free of improper financial influence. That's why they have clinicians fill out the conflict of interest disclosure forms annually.
Oh, I guess I didn't see it that way. Now, that probably explains why all those forms are all over my desk. I should probably take a look at them and see what I can and cannot do.
Probably not a bad idea.
You know, Randall, thanks a lot.
No problem. Have a good one, John.
Yeah, you too.